Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to talk about Split.js, an awesome JavaScript library that can help you split your web page or any element and create a resizable partition in just a few minutes. Ready? Let's check it out. There are two versions of Split.js, an original version which supports float and flex layout, and a new version for grid layout. For this tutorial, we will use the original one. First, you can install it from npm or just include it from CDN, it's up to you. This tutorial is going to use CDN for simplicity. So here's the example page. I added just three boxes to the page and centered them using flex layout. The current CSS I have is only just basic styling with background color, border, and padding. Now we can use the library by calling split and pass the array of element selector that you want to split. In this case, I will just pass the class name of each box. You will see that the boxes are separated. If you use the inspector, you will see that the library already added the invisible gutter line for you. Now we can show the gutter line and create a resizable partition by setting the height to anything. So, we will just set the gutter height to 100% and color to red. The reason why Split.js let you do this manually because they didn't want to interfere with your layout. They only compute the size and insert the invisible gutter and the rest is up to you. Now we will have the resizable gutter, but it's a bad UX. We should change the cursor to two-sided arrow on hover to let the user know this is resizable. Looks good. Now, there are some options that you are going to use pretty often in Split.js. First is the gutter size, pretty straightforward. You can change this to control the gutter line size. Next is the starting size of each partition. You can pass an array of percentage value like this. The last one is MinSize. This is where you will limit the minimum size of each partition before the gutter line will stop. Split.js also works in vertical mode. Just add direction vertical to the option. Then adjust your page layout accordingly. For this tutorial, we will just change the flex direction to column mode, then remove the gutter height setting and change the cursor direction to vertical two-sided arrow. With Split.js, you can now easily create amazing effect for your website. Here is the example using just Split.js and CSS fixed background. You can find the source code at the video description box below. So that's all for this tutorial. If you love this video, don't forget to like or subscribe if you are new to this channel. Stay tuned for the next update and see you next time. Bye!